Hey boys and girls, we are so glad that you are here. Just like class, just like your regular Sunday school class, we'll come to you every week with a different lesson, a different teacher, we'll do some worship, and really give you the word of God. So just like class, we have our classroom rules, whether you're crisscross applesauce on the floor, or you're sitting at the dining room table, or you're on the sofa, let's make sure we're sitting up straight, big and tall. We want you to make sure you have your listening ears on, all right? So we can't be talking, we can't be distracted. We need you to listen up, and we want you to look up. So if you're watching on your phone or your tablet, you're watching on television with mom and dad, put all the other things away so you're not distracted, so you can pay attention to what's going on. To start, boys and girls, let's do a little worship. If you all could stand up, let's shake out the worms, let's get excited, let's be ready. Here we go.
Get on your feet and worship with us.
Now, who can tell me what it means when Jesus lives inside of us? Yes, the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit lives inside of us. So today we're going to do a demonstration of the Holy Spirit living inside of us and protecting us. And we're going to have a helper today.
Hey, Miss Natalie, how are you?
Hi, Teacher Danny. Good, how are you?
I'm good, thank you. What do we have here? What is all this about?
So today we're going to talk about the Holy Spirit protecting us.
Oh, cool.
These tools that you can find at home.
Okay.
Okay. So what you're going to need is a bowl.
All right, we have a bowl.
Water. Dish soap.
Mom's good dish soap.
Yep. And pepper.
Pepper. Don't sniff it.
You might sneeze. Okay, so the first thing you're going to do is you're going to pour water into the bowl.
Okay.
The water represents the world.
How much water?
Just a little bit.
That's good?
Yes.
All right.
The next thing you're going to do is you're going to grab the pepper. Oh. And you're going to pour some pepper into the bowl.
So do I use the big opening or the little
opening? Just the little opening.
The little opening?
Yeah.
With the holes, the poured in holes? Okay. How much pepper?
I'll tell you when to stop.
Okay.
That's good.
Wow. That's a pretty good amount of pepper. Can you all see that? That's like all the surface of the water is covered with pepper.
Now some of you guys might ask, what is the pepper? What represents the pepper? The pepper represents the bad stuff.
Ooh, like when I fall down and get hurt?
No, it represents mean people or sickness.
What about like when grandma died?
Yes, that too.
Okay.
So that stuff can affect our lives. So we're going to have Teacher Danny pour his finger into the bowl.
Just stick it in?
Yeah, so what do you think? Before you do that, what do you think will happen when he puts his finger into the bowl?
My finger's gonna get wet.
Okay, let's see.
Oh wow, like all the pepper stuck to my finger.
The pepper stuck to his finger.
Oh, that's gross.
That means the bad stuff stuck to his finger. So if we let the bad stuff, if we let the negative stuff affect us, then it's going to affect how we live.
Can I wipe this off?
Yes.
Good. I don't want all that bad stuff on my finger.
So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to grab the dish soap. The dish soap represents the Holy Spirit, the good stuff.
Okay.
Now what do you think the good stuff means?
Chocolate. It means chocolate.
Chocolate? What else?
My family. Mm-hmm. Christmas presents.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, so let's see what happens when we pour the Holy Spirit into our lives.
How much?
Oh, just a little bit.
Wow, like all the pepper
disappeared.
It all like went to the side of the bowl. There's like no pepper. Wait, I gotta show you this. Can you all see this? All the pepper moved away when I poured the dish soap in.
Okay, now let's see what happens when Teacher Danny puts his finger into the bowl. Do you think the pepper's still going to stick onto his finger? Let's see.
Like right in the center? Like?
Yes.
Whoa, nothing. Nothing, no pepper at all. Pretty cool.
Now that's what happens when we have the Holy Spirit in our lives.
So, does that mean if I have the Holy Spirit in my life that nothing bad will ever happen?
No, bad stuff are still going to happen, but our minds are going to be different. We're going to think differently. We're not going to be afraid as much as if we didn't have the Holy Spirit in our lives.
Ow! So, like I won't be as scared?
Yeah, you won't be as scared.
Oh, nice. Okay, I get it. That makes sense.
Yeah.
Nice, Teacher Natalie.
Now that was a really good demonstration of how the Holy Spirit protects us. Yeah. Now we're going to show a video of when the Holy Spirit first comes into the 12 disciples' lives.
Nice.
The Holy Spirit comes. Acts chapter 2.
Thousands of people went to Jerusalem to celebrate a Jewish holiday called Pentecost. They came from many countries and spoke many different languages. Jesus' disciples were staying there. They were praying together. Suddenly, a noise filled the room. It sounded like a strong wind blowing. The Holy Spirit appeared as tongues of fire on each of them. They started talking in languages they did not know. The people in Jerusalem heard the noise and came to see what was happening. The crowd was amazed and asked,
"How are you able to speak our languages?"
Peter said,
"The prophets told us this would happen."
Then Peter told them about God's plan.
God sent Jesus to save everyone from the bad things we have done.
The people asked,
"What should we do?"
Peter replied,
"Ask Jesus to forgive you for your sins and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ."
On that day, 3,000 people believed in Jesus. The disciples baptized all of them.
I hope you guys really enjoyed that video. So the three main points that we got from that video and our demonstration is that Jesus lives inside of us. The second point is that the Holy Spirit covers us in peace. And the third is we can live fearless with Jesus.
That's right, absolutely.
Now, bad things still happen to us, but with Jesus, we can live fearless with Him. Now let's say all together that Jesus lives inside of us. We do not have to be afraid. Jesus lives inside of us. We do not have to be afraid.
Nice.
Good job, boys and girls.
Hey, Teacher Natalie, thanks so much for having me. This was fun. I really like that. You guys should try that at home. And don't forget to practice your memory verse, Luke 24:6. We'll see you all next time.